Today we want to go over fruits in flowering plants and the different classifications that we can find when we think about fruits in flowering plants. And we're going to begin then talking about simple fruits. Simple fruits are formed from one ovary, and they come in various forms. So a simple fruit, one ovary. Within that category of simple fruits from one ovary, you can have the seed, the mature seed, encased by the fruit. Things like tomatoes, cherries, and apples are examples of simple fruits, one ovary, with the seed being encased, the mature seed encased by the fruit. Also within this category, you can have the seeds on the outside. So it's still a simple fruit from one ovary, but the seeds are on the outside. Things like corn and strawberries would be examples then of simple fruits with the seeds on the outside rather than encased. And then the last category we want to look at under simple fruits is botanical fruits. These are fruits developed out of a flower. So once again, you've got a simple fruit, one ovary, a flower develops, and out of that flower comes the fruit. Things like tomatoes, squash, and eggplant would be representative samples of botanical fruits. Then, botanical fruits was not the last one. The last one we want to talk about is dry fruits. So also from simple fruits formed from one ovary, you can get dry fruits. This basically means the one ovary, the outer layer of it hardens around the seed, and you get things like peanuts and walnuts in this category of dry fruits. So under simple fruits, one ovary, you have the seed encased, the seed on the outside, botanical fruits developing out of a flower, and dry fruits, the outer wall of the ovary hardening. Then the next category of fruits in flowering plants that we want to talk about are aggregate fruits. In this situation, you've got many ovaries individually fertilized that then expand and develop from one flower, and you get the entire fruit from that. So many ovaries individually fertilized, one flower, and things like raspberries and blackberries would fall under this category. And when you look at them, you can see all the little individual ones. Then the final one under fruits and flowering plants is multiple fruits. In this category, you have not one flower, but many flowers in one single structure. Many flowers from one single structure. And here, think of things like pineapples and figs. Multiple flowers, a single structure. Aggregate fruits, many ovaries, one flower. Simple fruits, one ovary. So start here, one ovary, many ovaries, many flowers. We've listed some examples of each one of those, and this is a good classification system for keeping in mind the various forms of fruits in flowering plants.